Good day, everybody. In this video, I'd like to see if we can use Copilot to estimate stresses in soil mass. So we're going to look at two examples that I've prepared. So the first one will be about a clay of 5 meters and the lake of 3 meters above at point A, which is 2 meters below the ground. And we know the unit weight of clay, which is not the difficult example, pretty straightforward. We're going to estimate the total stress and pour the pressure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my snip tools, and then I'm going to copy this image, and then let's put it in the Copilot. So we get the image in Copilot, and just a little bit lazy, I'm just going to copy and paste the equation in Copilot. Okay. Let's see what Copilot is going to. So the correct answer should be 69.4 kPa. Okay, so let's see what it says. The answer is not correct. So depth of 3 meters, pressure 3 times 9.1. Okay, that's correct. So then we have another 2 meters times 20. So weight of below is 5 meters 6, so clay 0.5 minus 2. Okay, so it doesn't really see that it should be 2 meters, right? It says 3 meters here, unit weight of 20. Okay, so this is not correct. So the mistake is here, clay above point A should be 2 meters. It says here 2 meters, right? So it doesn't understand. Okay, so probably not very smart in this example, but let's see if it can calculate pore water pressure. So pore water pressure, maybe it will be a little bit easier. So let's see pore water pressure. Pore water pressure should be 49.05 kPa. So it should be, the formula is correct. So we have pore water pressure, which is unit weight times H. Depth below the water table. So the depth should be 5 meters. Okay, so this is correct. So pore water pressure is correct. So yeah, so look, we have here 3 meters of the lake and 2 meters of water above point A. Together will be 5 meters. 5 meters times the unit weight of water, 9.81, 49.5. Okay, well, it actually calculates pore water pressure, but it didn't calculate the total stress because it made a mistake with the drawings. Okay, so let's look at the second example. So second example is here. So we have another one. It's a little bit more difficult because here we have additional load of 25 kPa. Then we have silty clay. It has the unit weight of 20. And we have groundwater level here, which is 2 meters below the surface. We would like to estimate the effective stress at point A, but we can start again with total stress and pore water pressure. I'm going to copy this again, this image, and put it in the... Okay, so that will be the image. Let's start with the same question. We would estimate total stress, right? So what is the total stress at point A? That will be the first question. And here we go. So here the total stress will be, we would calculate 25, and then we're gonna add 12 meters times 20. And sum it up, right? Okay, so the formula is correct. Additional load plus guess, which is unit weight times depth. Correct. Additional load is 25. That's correct. Depth to point A, 12 meters, correct. Unit weight of silty clay is not specified. Okay, let's specify this one. So we didn't give this information. My bad. So let's say that this information. Consider this. Okay. So now it sees that 20 will be unit weight, correct? Stress due to surface load 25. Load above the water table 2 times 20. Well, it does it all correctly. So it looks at the above groundwater level, below groundwater level. In this case, the example is a little bit simplified because we have the unit with above and below groundwater 12 at 20. So it's the same. So it will be 25. Yeah. Okay. So that's correct. So now let's ask for effective stress, right? Calculate the effective. No, let's ask for water pressure. The water pressure at point A. Okay. So it should understand that I'm going to show you this example. So groundwater, we have 2 meters below the surface, and to point A is 12 meters from the surface. So here the HW, the one that amount of water above point A will be 10. So what we need to do is 10 multiply by the unit weight of water, which is 9.81. So the answer should be 98.1 kPa. Let's see if it got the correct answer. So for the pressure. Okay, so it got the correct answer. Very good. I'm really surprised I didn't do the first example first. Let's try it again. I want to see if we can redo the first example and estimate the total stress. I'm going to again put it in there. So see what is the reason. So we're going to back to the first example of the total stress because it couldn't solve it. And we give it a second chance. See if it's going to work or not. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it still says 89 instead of 69. It just adds another, doesn't calculate. I cannot see it from the picture that actually it's only 2 meters in the clay. What it does, 5 minus 2, right? Yeah. Okay, so it looks like Copilot is not perfect. So it does give correct results about water pressure. And in the second example, it could also figure out what is necessary, the amount of water and the level of groundwater level. So that was correct, but in this case, he just couldn't do it. Okay. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.